Welcome to Understand the Math. In this video, I'll go over a simple way to memorize the sines of trigonometric functions in each quadrant of the unit circle. I'll then work through some example problems where we'll find the quadrant where a trigonometric point is located. Before you begin, check out the description below to find a link to free guided notes that you can download and fill out as you watch this video. To determine the sine of all six trigonometric functions in each quadrant, we'll first look at the sines of x and y in each quadrant, and then relate cosine, sine, and tangent to x and y. Let's begin by writing down the quadrants in the unit circle pictured here. This is our first quadrant. To the left is our second quadrant. Below the second quadrant is our third quadrant. And to the right of the third quadrant is our fourth quadrant. In quadrant one, x is positive and y is positive, so we'll indicate that by a plus plus. In quadrant two, x is negative and y is positive, so that's a minus plus. In the third quadrant, both x and y are negative, so we have a negative negative. And in the fourth quadrant, x is positive, but y is negative, so that gives us a plus and a minus. To find the sines of our trigonometric functions, we'll draw a right triangle in our first quadrant. We'll let our angle be T. The bottom leg of the triangle is X. The side leg of the triangle is Y. And because we're dealing with a unit circle, the hypotenuse is equal to 1. We'll now relate cosine, sine, and tangent to x and y. Cosine t is adjacent over hypotenuse, so that's equal to x. Sine t is opposite over hypotenuse, so that's y. And then tangent is sine over cosine, so that's y over x. Or you can think of it as opposite over adjacent. Secant t is 1 over cosine t, so that's 1 over x. Cosecant t is 1 over sine t, so that's 1 over y. And then lastly, cotangent t is 1 over tangent t, so that becomes x divided by y. I want us to notice now that the sines of the cofunctions are going to be the same. So let's just say these are the same sines. We'll now determine the sines of cosine, sine, and tangent in each quadrant. In the first quadrant, x and y are positive, so cosine is positive, sine is positive, and then tangent is sine over cosine, so that's positive. In the second quadrant, x is negative and y is positive, so cosine's negative, sine is positive, and then tangent is sine over cosine, so a positive divided by a negative gives us a negative. In the third quadrant, both x and y are negative, so cosine's negative, sine's negative, and then tangent is a negative divided by a negative, so tangent's positive. In our fourth quadrant, x is positive, y is negative, so cosine's positive, sine is negative, and then tangent, being sine over cosine, is negative. Let's now summarize which functions are positive and highlight these in yellow. Cosine's positive, sine's positive, tangent is positive in the first quadrant. In the second quadrant, sine is positive. Third quadrant, tangent is positive. And on our fourth quadrant, cosine is positive. So in the interior, we'll write all positive in the first quadrant. Second quadrant, sine is positive. In the third quadrant, tangent's positive. And then in the fourth quadrant, cosine is positive. And these need to be memorized. And on the next page, I'm going to show you an easy way to be able to remember which of these functions are positive in each quadrant. Mnemonics can help us remember the signs of the trigonometric functions in different quadrants of the unit circle. We'll begin by highlighting the first letter of the function or functions that are positive in each quadrant. So in quadrant one, all the functions are positive, so we're going to highlight A. In the second quadrant, sine is positive, so we'll highlight S. In the third quadrant, tangent is positive, so we highlight T. And then in the fourth quadrant, cosine is positive, so we highlight C. We'll now write down two mnemonics that can help us remember that. So in the first quadrant, we need a word to remember the letter A for all functions being positive. So that is going to be the word all. In the second quadrant, we need to remember S, so we're going to remember that by the word students. In the third quadrant, we need to remember T. We'll remember that by the word take. And then in our fourth quadrant, we need to remember C, and we'll remember that by the word calculus. So the phrase to remember is all students take calculus, going from quadrant one all the way to quadrant four. The second mnemonic that I'm going to write down is one that I learned recently from one of my student learning assistants. And he told me that he learned the phrase add sugar to coffee. And that's another nice way to remember which functions are positive. Let's now look at some example problems where we're given the sine of two trigonometric functions, and we want to determine the quadrant where the point x of t, y of t is located. In our first problem, sine t is positive. So sine is going to be positive in quadrants 1 and 2. Cosine is negative, and that can happen in quadrants 2 and quadrants 3. So we want to choose the quadrant where both of these are going to be true. So that's going to be quadrant 2. So what this tells us is if sine is positive and cosine is negative, our point x of t, y of t has to be located in the second quadrant. In the second problem, tangent t is positive, so that can happen in quadrants 1 and in quadrants 3. And then sine t is negative, and that happens in quadrants 3 and quadrants 4. So the quadrant common to both of those is quadrant 3. For our last problem, cosecant t is negative. So that means sine t is negative, and that can happen in quadrants 3 and 4. Secant t is positive, so that means cosine is positive, and that can happen in quadrants 1 in quadrants 4. So the quadrant common to both of these is quadrant 4. I would encourage you to take some time to memorize which trigonometric functions are positive in each of the four quadrants. If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day. If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.